blind date, baby. Bad bitch, no underwear. 2020 gon' pull up an egg, yeah. Bitch, I know if you can go home. Uber, Uber everywhere, yeah.
Bad bitch, no underwear. So IMDb is just sick, and it's like, you know, she's just one of those artists that I feel like we all kind of watch and we're like, I wish I had that much sauce all the time. It's so nice to have a fresh wave of music coming out of the UK, and yeah, she's sick. Working 9 to 5, what a way to make a living, barely getting by. Dolly Parton. My mum told me that she had written "And I will always love you," and I was just super excited because I was like, "What? Who is this songwriter?" And then I remember when I heard Jolene for the first time, and 9 to 5 is one of my favourite songs. Every time the weekend comes, yeah, I know that it won't be long, yeah. So you're gonna call my phone, yeah. You'll be like, babe, come over. This is my like latest single, and it's called "I Wish I Missed My Ex." I'd written so many songs about boys being bad, and I wanted to write a song where, you know, I was kind of talking about having a person in my life that was amazing and letting them go just because they weren't right for me. And I think it was just my way of saying to them, you know, I wish I missed you, but I don't. So yeah. Some girls are only about that thing, that thing, that thing. So that is Lauryn Hill, Doo Wop. I think she's one of my biggest inspirations, especially when it comes to my music. She's just, for me, a really timeless artist and a really strong female artist that I really look up to. I got my hair, got my hair, got my brains, got my ears, got my eyes, got my nose, got my mouth. Oh, that voice. My mum used to play this game with me where she'd put on loads of different female voices and she'd say, guess the voice, guess the voice, guess the voice. And Nina's was the only voice that I could always guess. Nina Simone has got one of the most distinctive voices. And I think that was always really important for me, was that I wanted to have a distinctive voice. I wanted people to listen to my voice and go, that's Mahalia. Except you've got that look in your eye when I'm telling a story and you find it boring, you're thinking of something to say. So, Kate Nash. Kate Nash, I listened to when I was like 12, and I was just, do you know what? That album came out, and I was really upset about this boy, and I just felt like she just said everything that I was feeling really well. And so the thing with Kate Nash actually was that I, for ages, was trying to imitate her. I really wanted to have her accent when I was singing, and I was jealous that like she could do that really cool British thing, and I was like, I want to do that. Bitch, you can fuck with me if you wanted to. These expensive, these is red bottoms, these is bloody shoes. Cardi B. Now, Cardi B is just really doing it for me right now. Every time I get in the car, I always have to play her music. I'm always just like, she's the best thing in the world. I love her. I love her realness. I don't feel like Cardi B is fake in any way, and I just love that about her. Great song, great song.